The long spell of untimely rains was a blessing for water-scarce Tamil Nadu. New plants and fresh leaves turned the dry countryside into a lovely green. As we went along the countryside, strains of folk music fell on our ears. In stark contrast to the blaring sounds of film music on the radio, it was a welcome relief. Fascinated by the folk music, we looked out for a folk singer in Ramanathapuram, a village near Thanjavur.
நம்ம கதவுக சாட்சி சொல்லும் தண்ணீரண்ணானே.
The village had sparse vegetation. It was a small hamlet inhabited by people of low social and financial status. And most families practiced one form of folk art or another. When we expressed our desire to know more about folk dances, the women readily agreed to perform and organized themselves to do a folk dance, the kolatam. Our aim was to cover the folk dance called Karagatam. Karagatam is a very old dance form. The Tamil epic Chilapadikadam refers to this dance as Kudakutu or pot dance. In Chilapadikadam, Lord Krishna played Kudakutu in the palace of Bana while he was on a rescue mission. Panchali also played Karagatam to get away from the hands of Timrasura.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Tim, the taki, the tim, the taki, the ta.
In earlier times, the weaker sections of the society did not have the opportunity or the means to learn classical art forms, which were performed mostly at the king's court or in temples. Both were out of bounds for these sections. Probably this divide gave rise to the rich repertoire of art forms like Karagatam, which were passed on from one generation to the next. The village temple was an ideal setting for the performance of these folk art forms. As in early times, even today, rural women bring water from the river or a well in a pot on their head. Most probably, the Karagatam dance may have borrowed the idea of balancing the pot on the head from this. There are two types of Karagatam. If the dance is performed as an offering to Mariamma, the village goddess, it is called Shaktikargam. In this dance, the pot on the head is filled with water and it is treated as goddess Mariamma. Dr. Murugeshan, who has done research on Karagatam, says,
every village of Tamil Nadu, in olden days, Karagam, that is Shakti Karagam, is performed for the goddess Mariamma in the villages. For fulfilling the woe fulfilling or prayer fulfilling, the pious man carries a newly earthen pot from the river or a holy well. The water filled in the pot is considered to be very essential. It is pious. It is like goddess of Mariamma. The pusari or a pious man carries this pot throughout the village streets with Nayandi Melam and finally arrives at the temple, a erected platform. There the festival begins and it goes on for 3 days or 4 days.
The Karagam, which has no religious connotations, is called Atta Karagam. Here, instead of water, the pot is filled with sand or rice, which helps to maintain the balance of the pot on the head. The pot is decorated and a model parakeet is placed on top of the pot. This parakeet is considered as goddess Madurai Meenakshi. The goddess also has a parakeet on her shoulder. It is believed that Madurai Meenakshi helps to keep the balance of the pot. There are more than 50 types of movements in Karagatam, including the footwork, movement of body, hands and head.
Karagatam is having three important parts. That is, one is Adavu, that is step system, and the other one is music system, and the third one is synchronization of these two. Karagatam has more than 50 Adavus in olden days. Now the Karagatam players are doing only 5 to 15 Adavus. If the talented artists are asked to, they can perform with 30 or 40 Adavus. We are encouraging them or insisting them to do all the Adavus. In Adavus, very simple Adavus are there in Karagatam, like this. And then like this, and very intrinsic adavus like this, or like this, the adavus are going.
The dance is performed in three stages. Vilamba, where the movements are slow. Madhyama, where the movements are faster than Vilamba. Turitha, with very fast movements. The music provides the changeover from one stage to another. The tala, in combination with jati, controls the dance.
Tim tatta ki tatta.
Karagatam is performed with the accompaniment of two tabal, two pambai, one kudiketi, a small cymbal and two nadaswaram. When all these instruments are played together, it is known as Nayandi Melam. Nayandi Melam is the musical accompaniment for other folk dances also. Nadaswaram and tabal are also known as Mangalavadyam. These are played on auspicious occasions like marriage, festival and puja in temples. Nadaswaram is also a classical concert instrument in Carnatic music. Karagatam is performed by both men and women. In early days, the Karagatam dancers used to wear the costumes of peasant men and women. Now, with the change of times, female dancers wear colorful saris. They also wear chilanga or anklets. But life is not as colorful as it looks. Folk artists as such are a deprived lot. Coming from the lower rungs of society, they find it difficult to get acceptance by elite sponsors. Besides, today, most of us prefer modern dances. So the only alternative for the folk artist is to make use of the brief festival season to eke out a living. For the rest of the year, they pick up odd jobs for survival. Still, they contribute to the society by preserving these folk arts. It is only through their efforts that these art forms remain alive today. This sad state does not prevent them from devoutly practicing this art form. We went to a temple in another village to see their performance. there, forgetting their hardships, placing their sorrows at the feet of their gods, hoping that a day will come when they are recognized. They danced.